Hello viewers, welcome to you all in this new lecture on switchgear and its component. I am Dr. Vijaysharma, Assistant Professor in Department of Physics, Government Mahila Engineering College, Ajmer. The switchgear covers an important part of electrical sector and it is not a single object. In general, it refers to the position of electrical system's normal activity, and that includes connectors, detectors and protecting devices, etc. So let us take a look what are the contents of this video lecture. In this video lecture we will study about what is a switch gear, then the evolution of a switch gear, what are the essential features or characteristics of switch gear, and electrical components that comes under the category of this switch gear. So let us start with this. So what is a switch gear? So the apparatus which is used for switching, controlling and protecting any device which can be used for these purposes is considered to be a switch gear. And the switchgear has to perform the function of carrying, making and breaking the normal load current like a switch. Okay, and the term switchgear is a generic term and it covers a wide range of products like breakers, circuit breakers, switches, SFUs, switch units, offload isolators, HRCs and connectors, ELCBs, that is earth leakage circuit breakers, etc. And there also has to be provision for metering, controlling and data, wherein innumerable devices are used for achieving the switching function. Let us take a look how the switch gear evolution comes. The switch gear equipment is essentially concerned with the switching and interrupting currents, either under normal condition or in abnormal operation condition. So this is the fundamental part why we require the switch gear. And the tumbler switch, it is a normal switch which we use generally at our homes, offices, etc. And it is with an ordinary fuse, is the simplest form. We can see it anywhere in our, even in your room you can watch it. And it was used to control and protect the lights, that is electricity and other equipments in home and offices. Just to on off the fan you require a switch, and that is as similar as the tumbler switch. For circuit of high rating, that is HRC, it stands for high rupturing capacity refuges, in conjunction with the switch may serve the purpose of controlling and protecting the circuits. However, switch gear cannot be used profitably on a high voltage system. So if you have a high voltage system of order of suppose to be 33 kV, then these switches which we are using at our homes are not useful. They are not economical also. So that is the issue. That's why we need the switch gear term. And there are two specific reasons for the same. And what are these two specific reasons is, firstly, when we use a fuse, so when a fuse blows, it takes some time to replace. I think you have seen the switchboard at your home, and you have also seen that whenever there is a power cut and due to some fault, fuse drops and breaks, then to replace it requires a time. And during this time, there is a consequently interruption in the service to the customer at our home, in study also. Secondly, this fuse cannot successfully interrupt large fault currents that result from the faults on the high voltage system. So when a short circuit occurs on the system, a heavy current flowing through the equipment, and that may cause considerable damage. So in order to be interrupt such heavy fault currents, what we need an ACB, that is automatic circuit breakers. And a circuit breaker is one switch gear, and what it does, which can open or close an electrical circuit under both the condition, normal condition as well as abnormal condition. So even in instance where a fuse is adequate as regard to breaking capacity, a circuit breaker may be preferable. So if we have the options with us, whether we have to choose the fuse and whether we have to choose the circuit breaker. So even fuse is adequate, it can be used easily for the purpose. However, we have to give preference to the circuit breaker due to its characteristic. Because the circuit breaker can close circuit as well as break them without replacement, and thus has a wide range of use than a fuse. So this is the purpose why we use switch gear instead of switches. So now let us move what are the essential features of a switch gear. The major role of switch gear in power system is to ensure the safe operation of the power system, and it ensures the people's safety also. So by ensuring the safe operation to the power system, it will also ensure the equipment protection and the personal who works in there. Many dangerous situations will arise from overcurrent and due to overvoltage by the occurrence of earth faults. It could cause high touch voltage and it will endanger people. So in order to continue the safe operation of the power system, the overcurrent and overvoltage must be prevented. So how we can prevent it? So that is why we need certain features that should be exist and that should be lies within the switch gears operation. So what are the features? We have to take one by one. So the essential features are, first is the reliability and the stability, and it is the most important part for the switch gear. The protection system must take care for the reliable operation of the relay so that the reliability can be improved. Reliable function can be referred to as a backup protection. Reliability can be reached by combining different protection principles. Example, that is distance and differential protection of transmission line. And if in switch gear it used and reliable operation, in case of fault occur in the system, switch gear must isolate the faulty part of the circuit from the remainder circuitry. So it should be reliable, as well it should be having a stability. And stability of the system is the quality of the system by which system remains stable and in operating and stable under certain condition. So whenever there will be overload and overload voltage or overload current, then in that case it should be sustained and should be in operating. So this should be the main feature of the switch gear. Also, it should having absolutely certain discrimination. So in this case, there could be many faults and disturbance in a power system. So it is impossible to provide protection against each and every fault or abnormal condition and due to economic reason. So instead of that, the system must provide adequate protection. So how it does? When fault occurs, so on any section of the power system, then the switch gear circuit must be able to discriminate between the faulty section and the good section. That means if there is a room, there is a building, in that building if a particular section is the faulty, in that part there is the overload current or the overload voltage, so this switch gear has the ability to differentiate or discriminate between the faulty section as well in the good section. So healthy section will be isolated from the defaulter section or the faulty section. So it should also learn the faulty section from the healthy section and without affecting any of the remaining part of the circuit. So this will ensure the continuity of the supply. It should also be gives us a quick operation, because when fault occurs on any part of the power system, the switch gear must operate quickly so that no damage is done to generator, transformer and any other equipment by the short circuit current. So if fault is not cleared by switch gear quickly, it is likely to spread into healthy section or the healthy parts of the switch gear, thus endangering complete shutdown of the system. So it should give a quick operation so that no harm occurs to overall circuitry. That is the main purpose of this quick operation for the switch gear. It also gives us a provision for manual control. Switch gear must have manual control capability in case of any electrical or any failure of the circuit condition. So this is the also an important part. There should be a provision for instrument. What does it mean? That instrument provision are needed. It may be in the form of ammeter or voltmeter in the unit itself, or necessary current and voltage transformer for connecting to the main switchboard or the separate panel. It should be a simple structure. There should be no complex structure of the switch gear. So a protection system should be simple, so that it could be easily operated and maintained by the time. Now let us take what are the essential component for a switch gear. A switch gear essentially consists of many protecting devices such as switches, fuse, circuit breakers, isolators, relays, control panels, and current transformer, potential transformer, and various associated equipments. Some equipments are designed to operate under both normal condition as well as in normal condition. So during normal operations, switch gear permits to switch on or off generators, transmission lines, distributors, and other electrical equipments. However, when a failure, that is short circuit, occurs on any part of the power system, a heavy current flows through the equipment, and that threatening damage to the equipment and interruption of the service to the customer. So for that we have to use these different circuit breakers and the relays. So this is a schematic diagram of the component of the switchgear, that having high voltage switchgear protection, transmission line, high voltage switchgear protection, power transmission protection, and generator and the circuit breaker. So these are the all used for the protection, for the, because as we know that switchgear also gives the protection. So this is the structural part of the switchgear for a protection system. Now all these are the component of a switchgear, that include switches that having SFU, either air brake circuit, and fuses like HRC, high rupturing circuit, high breaking breaking circuit fuse. And it may have some circuit breakers that includes low voltage circuit breakers, include of ACB, earth circuit breaker, MCCB, molded case circuit breaker, ELCB, earth leakage circuit breaker, MCB, miniature circuit breaker. So these all are the circuit breakers in the low voltage circuit. Even in high voltage circuit, we can use oil circuit breaker, air blast circuit breaker. There should be certain relays. It contains instrument transformer, that is current transformer, voltage transformer. There is surge arresters, auto reclosers, and isolators, starter, capacitor. So these all are the component of a switchgear, and that is why it is called that switchgear is not a single object. It is a generic term, and it has a lot of equipment or items with it. So let us take a brief of some of these component of the switchgear. Let us start with this. So as we have discussed, that switchgear covers a wide range of equipment concerned with the switching and interrupting currents under both the cases, normal as well as abnormal. So let us take what are the features and the activities of this particular part. So when we have to take switch, so a switch is a device which is used to open or close an electric circuit, as we use in our electric board also. In a convenient way, we have to make switch on, off, on, off. So it can be used under a full load condition as well as in no condition, but it cannot interrupt the fault currents. That is the issue with this, it cannot interrupt the faulty currents. So for when the contacts of a switches are opened, an arc is produced. You have seen, also seen in some of the times in the circuit board, and an air between the contacts. So this is particularly true of high voltages and large current capacity. So the switches may be classified into these two ways. One is the air switches and one is the oil switches. In air brake switches, it is an air switch and it is designed to open a circuit under load. And in order to change that arc on opening such a switch, special arcing horn are provided. Okay. Similarly, we have oil switches, and as the name implies, the contact of switch, such switch are opened under oil. So usually transformer oil. Fuses, you all are aware with this fuse and switches. So what are the fuses? Is a fuse is a short piece of wire or thin strip which melts when excessive current flows through it for sufficient time. So whenever a overload current flows through this switch with this fuse, and since this is a very thin metal strip, so it will be melted due to the high temperature, and it is inserted in series with the circuit, which has to be protected. So when a short circuit or overload current occurs, the current through the fuse element increases beyond its rated capacity. So this increases the temperature and the fuse element melts or blows out. So disconnecting the circuit, and that is how it protects us with the overload current. Some other component which include in the switchgear is the circuit breaker. And a circuit breaker is an equipment which can open or close a circuit under all condition. That means with a no load condition, with a full load condition, and even in a faulty condition also. So it is so designed that it can be operated manually, or even sometimes it can also be controlled by the remote control. So under normal conditions and automatical under fault condition. Or for the later operation, a relay circuit is used with the circuit breaker, and it is generally of two categories, that is low voltage circuit breaker, even the high with the high voltage circuit breaker. In low voltage circuit breaker, which we have to seen in our homes, the included components are MCB, that is miniature circuit board, even there should be RCCB, that is residual current circuit board. And in high voltage circuit breakers, there are OL circuit breaker, there are air blast circuit breakers. Another component in the switch gear is the protective relays. So what is the actually a relay is, A relay is a device which detects and detects the fault and supplies information to the brake for circuit interruption. So relay will inform us, and due to that information, it will be disconnected from the circuit. So this relay gives a function that is to initiate a signal to circuit breakers for disconnecting the elements of the power system when it develops a fault. So whenever there will be fault in the circuit, it will inform us, inform the circuit. Some other parts includes the instrument transformer, and that instrument transformer consists of a current transformer as well as the voltage transformer used in switchgear installation for the measurement of electrical parameter for protection and metering purpose. As I already told you, that switchgear can also be used for the purpose of metering. So we can use it with the using of this current transformer or the voltage transformer. An instrument transformer in which the secondary current is substantially proportional to the primary current and differs in the phase from its approximately 0 degree, then it is considered to be current transformer. And for voltage transformer in which the secondary voltage is substantially proportional to the primary voltage and differs in phase it by approximately 0 degree, then it is said to be voltage transformer. Surge arrestor is another component which is used in the switch gear, and these are very important components of the switch gear and substation installation. These surge arrestors are used to protect the substation equipment from temporary overvoltages, switching impulses, light impulses, and very fast transient overvoltage. So these are the certain features we can make our instrument protect with these issues. Another part that is lies in the that is the component of the switchgear is the auto reclosers and the sectionalizers. And auto reclosers and sectionalizers are used in the distribution network of the medium voltage switchgear up to 33 kV. And these equipments are useful for the fast automatic restoration of supply following transient fault in the system. They develop automatically. So whenever there will be high voltage, then they can switch accordingly and they can protect the switchgear system and the whole structure which is connected with the supply. One another important term is the isolator, and isolators are devices which are generally operated offload to provide isolation of main plant item for maintenance on to isolate faulted equipment from the other live equipment. So air insulated or open terminal disconnectors are available in several form of different application. At low voltages, single brake type are used with either rocker type or single type and rotating post type being predominant. At high voltage, central post, double end post, vertical brake, etc. can be used. So this is all about the switch gears, its characteristic features, evolution, etc. So these are the references. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any query, you can write me at vijaysharma@gwec.ac.in. Thank you. In next video lecture, we will discuss about the classification of switchgear and the LT switchgear. Thank you.